Hello students, today we are going to learn chapter 9, that is the two horses. We have finished already the half of the chapter explanation and today we shall continue with the chapter. Do you remember the story? I hope you are remembering the story, okay? So, just we will memorize what we have learned in the previous class. So, once upon a time, there lived two horses. How many were there? Two of them. And what is the name of the horses? One was Lord's horse. Lord's horse means a rich man's horse. And the other one was the peasant horse. Peasant horse is a farmer's horse. One was rich man's horse and one was the farmer's horse. So they both were very good friends. Okay. So whenever they met each other, they had a lot of things to share. And they were great good friends. And one day what happened? One day the Lord's horse told something that badly hurt his friend's feeling. Okay, one day the Lord's horse said something to the peasant horse that he was very much hurt by that. Okay, unlike me, what he told? Unlike me, the Lord's horse told that he was little proud, I think. So unlike me, you are of the common breed. You are of an ordinary kind of horse. I am always harnessed to catch and to the wagon. So I am always tied to the wagon and I am fed on barley. And also I look so beautiful on my feet. There is nothing. My feet are very clean and look so beautiful. So he said the who said this? The Lord's horse told that I look so beautiful and my feet are very clean, no dirt, and it looks so beautiful. And I am given the I am fed on barley. And and you, he compared himself to the peasant horse. So, and you are always tied to the coach. And also, your legs are caked with mud. Your legs are fully with mud. And so dirty you looks. And also you are fed, what? Straw. You are given straw to eat. So he compared so many things with that. So the peasant horse might have been felt very bad. He was very upset by hearing this. Of course, but anyway, the peasant horse agreed to all that what he told. He told that I can run also very fast. Who told this? The Lord's horse told that I can move very fast as wind. So I can run very fast as wind. And you cannot run even as a snail. You cannot outrun. Outrun means you cannot run fast even as the snail. Snail means a creature with a moves very slowly. Okay. So, everything the peasant horse agreed. Whatever the Lord's horse told to him, he agreed everything. Okay. So, finally what happened? They agreed. Finally the peasant horse told that I cannot run outrun a snail, but I can run outrun you. Okay. So by hearing this, the Lord's horse was very angry. So they decided, both decided to have a, then they, it was agreed that they would run a race. But they agreed finally they would run a race. They would run circling the meadow. Meadow means the grass land. They would circle the meadow and they not stopping till one of them was defeated. That was the agreement. Do you remember the agreement? Yes. What is the agreement? They would run circling the meadow and not stopping till one of them was defeated. Okay. One of them was defeated means one would get tired and stop. That means the other one is, other one win. No, that is the, that is the agreement they both decided. They would run circling the grassland. The Lord's horse, as soon as they have decided, the Lord's horse was very proud. He started to run and run ahead of the peasant horse. The first round he took, the second round he took. The Lord's horse was not tired. He was running ahead of the peasant horse, and he was teasing and asking, "Isn't it time for rest? Will you? You will get tired." Who was telling this? The Lord's horse asking to the peasant horse, "Whether are you my friend? Are you tired?" So I warned. Don't you fear? The peasant horse replied. What's the peasant horse replied? "No, you don't worry about me. I am not at all tired." So this much we have explained yesterday. Today we shall continue the rest of the part of the lesson. Okay. So you can also take page number 52. While I read, you can also take the textbook and look at the sentences. In the fourth round also, the Lord's horse got ahead of the peasant horse. But he neighed less loudly now. So how many round the Lord's horse was ahead of the peasant horse? In the fourth round also, the Lord's horse was ahead of the peasant horse because he was running very fast. Okay. Now, slowly, slowly what happened? He was getting little bit tired. "Isn't it time for you to rest a little? You will get tired." Who asked this? The Lord's horse. He was getting little tired. He was, and when we read this line, we can understand that his voice also is little feeble. He is little weak. "I won't never fear," the peasant horse replied, "but you seem all out of breath." So peasant horse told the Lord's horse, "I think you are little bit tired. You are out of breath. You are not getting the breath." You can imagine that when you take a round, when you run once or twice around the meadow or anywhere when you go participate in running race, so once or twice you run, the third time you will be also out of breath. The same way this Lord's horse also was out of breath. He was getting little tired. "It is because I hurt my foot," the Lord's horse lied. So what he told? I am not tired, but I hurt my foot," the Lord's horse replied. He was not accepting the reality. No, he was tired, but he did not tell. He told a lie to the peasant horse. In the fifth round, he again got ahead of the peasant horse, but this time he neither neighed nor called out. In the fifth round, he took the five round he has taken. He again got ahead of the peasant, but still he was ahead of the peasant horse. But this time he was unable to make any noise because almost he was tired. "Why are you groaning, friend?" Groaning means cry. "Why are you crying, my friend?" the peasant horse asked to the Lord's horse. "Why are you crying? Are you tired?" So this time what excuse the Lord's horse gave to the peasant horse? "I stumbled on a stone," replied the Lord's horse. So Lord's horse, this time what excuse he gave? "No, my dear friend, I am not tired, but I stamped on. I slipped my feet on a stone. That is why I am little bit tired. I can't even talk." In the sixth and seventh round, the Lord's horse could not overtake the peasant horse. So, till fifth round, the Lord's horse was ahead of the peasant horse. But when it comes in the sixth and seventh round, the peasant horse overtook the Lord's horse. In the eighth round, the peasant horse caught up with the Lord's horse and then passed him. So now till fifth round, the Lord's horse was ahead of the peasant horse, but he was losing his stamina. He was little weak and he was unable to take breath. He was out of breath and he was tired almost, but he was making a lot of excuse. He told Raja, what excuse he gave? "I hurt my feet, that is why I am unable to run." And the second he told Raja, I stamped on a stone. And now the peasant horse overtook the Lord's horse. "Why have you fallen behind, friend? Tired?" asked he. "Why are you fallen? down behind. You were always ahead of me. Now what happened? Why are you behind? Who asked this? The peasant horse asked the Lord's horse. So this time what excuse he gave? No, I paused in order to think, the Lord's horse replied. So he told what excuse this time? No, I am not tired, you know, that I just paused myself to what? To think. I am just reflecting on about what we don't know. So I am moving little slow. I am slowly coming. I am just thinking on. Okay, who replied this? The Lord's horse replied. In the ninth round, the Lord's horse stopped running. He dropped down on the ground. So in the ninth round, what happened? He was unable to move ahead. So he dropped down. He had fallen down. Okay, and on the ground. What is the matter? Don't you feel well? The peasant horse asked. So what's the matter? Why are you not running? Why are you falling down? Why are you sitting on the ground? What happened? Who asked this? The peasant horse asked the Lord's horse. So let us see what excuse he gave this time. No, it is just that a house or horse fly is disturbing me. Horse fly means an insect, no? You have seen an insect disturbing the animals. When they sit and only can see the flies coming and sitting on that, no? So, what excuse this time he gave? He gave that a horse fly is disturbing me. That is why it is biting me all over. It is biting me all over my body, so I am unable to run. That is why I am sitting just chase away the fly. That's why I am sitting. You understood what's the matter? Yes. I'll drive it off and then run on again. Okay. Okay, what happened? I will chase it away and I will run again. We have plenty of time. Isn't it? We have plenty of time, no? So I am just taking sitting down on the ground. For what I am sitting down? The horse fly is disturbing me because I wanted to chase it out. So that's the reason he told this time to the peasant horse. But anyway, you know why? What's the reason? The real reason is he is almost out of breath and he is very, very tired. When the peasant horse was on his 10th round, the Lord's horse got up and went behind some bushes. So the peasant horse already have taken the 10th round. He is not tired. He is not running fast also, no? He is taking his time and running, but he is covering almost all the round. He covered up his 10th round also. So when he was on the 10th round, the Lord's horse got up and went behind the bushes. Bushes means you can see it on the bush. So many trees are there, no? So behind one of the trees, who went? The Lord's horse went behind the trees. He avoided looking at the peasant horse. Now he was really ashamed of to look at the peasant horse because he has told so many lies and excuses. Then he started eating the grass. He was hungry also, no? So he started to eat. Who went? You understood the story? Who went behind the bushes? The Lord's horse went behind the bushes when the peasant horse was taking the 10th round. Okay, he was almost tired and the Lord's horse went behind the bushes and he started to eating the grasses. You can see it in the picture. It is given here. It is dinner time. Then your lordship, the peasant horse called out him. So the peasant horse now got a chance to tease the Lord's horse. The beginning part we see that the Lord's horse was teasing the, telling proudly about himself. That he can run as fast as a, run fast like a move, the movement of the wind, you know, it all that. So now the peasant horse is teasing the Lord's horse. Is it dinner time, my lordship? The peasant horse called out him. It is supper time, the Lord's horse replied. What the Lord's horse replied? It is supper time. I am having my supper. You may also take a rest. We have plenty of time to run around before morning. So you please come. The Lord's horse is now calling the peasant horse also. Please come. We have enough time to take the round. I am already hungry, so I am eating the grass, and you also come and have your supper. So then what the peasant horse told? I don't need rest, said the peasant horse. I am only just starting to warm up. I'll run another 10 rounds and then another, and after that we will see. I am not at all tired. Who told this? The peasant horse told. I am not at all tired. I have taken the 10th round. The 10th round, I mean that I am warming up my body. Okay, I will take it 10 more rounds. And then another 10 more rounds. Then only I will think of taking the rest. That is the answer the peasant horse told to the Lord's horse. You understood, no? How the story is. And from that day on, the Lord's horse never turned up his nose at anyone anymore. So, never turned up his nose. That means he has never teased or said about proudly about himself. Okay, so that is the end of the story. So, who won the prize? Who won the race? The peasant horse won the race. The Lord's horse was almost tired when he was or 6th or 7th round, he was almost tired. And he made 2-3 excuses and he sat on the floor. In between he went and took his supper. He had he went behind the bushes, hiding the bushes, and had his supper, telling that I am very hungry, I am eating the grass. So finally we can say that who won the race? The peasant horse. He was very, though he was the farmer's horse, he was very hard working and he could run very easily, you know, though he looks ugly or whatever it is, he was very intelligent. He took the round very quietly. He was not at all tired running. 10 round he took. He told that again I will take 10 more round. Okay, so now we can conclude the lesson by saying that who is the winner of the race? The peasant horse is the winner of the race. Okay. So what is the moral of the story? From this story we have learned. Whenever we learn a lesson, we learn something for ourselves also, isn't it? So what we have learned from the lesson? Eh? They were great friends, you know, the horses, two horses, the Lord's horse and the peasant horse. Both were good friends. But sometimes the Lord's horse was, we see that the beginning part, he was little proud, no? Okay, so because of that, in between them, the competition, the competitive spirit came, and who is the winner of the race? Okay, so we can understand that we can say the moral of the story is that never underestimate a person's ability. Never underestimate a person's ability. That's the moral of the story. Everybody, God has created each and everybody with his own values, yes, his own abilities, no? We cannot underestimate anybody, no? Each person God has given different talents. One may be good at in one thing or the other may be good at one thing. So we have to appreciate each other. Whatever the ability God has given in you or the another, we have to appreciate each other and go hand in hand with each other. That is the moral of the story. So what's the moral of the story? Never underestimate a person's ability. Abilities means the ability to do something. Everybody has its own ability. Okay. Okay. So what is the homework you have to do? You have to read the story. You will understand very easily, very simple it is. So you read the lesson once or twice and you write it down in your fair copy, the word meanings, okay? The word meanings, you will write it down in the fair copy. And tomorrow I will be giving you the question answers and the filling the blanks. And the question answer also, you will be writing it in your fair copy. Thank you, students, for listening.